Zach Robinson. I'm Steve Palazzolo. Today discussing Dak Prescott of the Dallas Cowboys and just what can we expect from him heading into year three with Dak. He comes in as a rookie and just
lights it up.
Unbelievable, right? Yeah. Completely takes the NFL by storm, had an unbelievable rookie season. Last year took a bit of a step back, no matter which way you measure it, whether it's statistically, whether it's PFF grade. PFF grade goes from 84.4 in 2016, number 10 in the NFL, down to 80.5, number 17 in the NFL last year. What are your high-level overall thoughts of Dak so far 2 years into the league?
I think you got to be impressed either way. Obviously, last season, you can simply say he just wasn't as accurate throwing the football. You can look at the offensive line issues in some of those games. Didn't play as well. It was under pressure and didn't play as well under pressure. But in terms of what you got out of a fourth-round pick and a couple years ago to a legitimate top tier, I would say, you know, at least top half of the NFL guy, you got to be happy with a guy like Dak Prescott pulling trigger.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, when you look at it from that perspective, what you've gotten from a fourth-round pick, yeah. The accuracy that you brought up, he went from number 14 in the NFL in our throw-by-throw accuracy data, saying where did he put the ball? Did he put it perfect? Did he put it right on the frame? 14th in 2016, down to 25th last year. Yeah. You guys can find all of that accuracy data in our PFF QB annual, all part of Edge and Elite, those packages that bring all of the goodies for you. So as we're looking forward and we're looking at what happened last year, you know, offensive line issues, there's the one game he got sacked. He had no shot against the Atlanta Falcons, yeah. Right? Adrian Claiborne has six sacks. The big thing with his rookie season, everybody said, well, yeah, but he's got the Dallas offensive line. Yeah, but he's got Zeke Elliott in this running game. How much was that a factor last year for Dak?
I think it's got to be a huge factor. Ezekiel Elliott took so much pressure off of him, just down to down, getting him in more third manageables. In terms of just, he's a very good zone thrower. A lot of teams would bring down guys, play more man-to-man last season. So if they can get him back on track, Ezekiel Elliott, offensive line, because he does need some of those pieces together to kind of do what he does best.
So what we saw even his rookie season was he would have some really bad games. He would have some pretty rough games, but always bounce back. Some rough games against the Philadelphia Eagles, against the New York Giants. Seems like a lot of them are coming against the NFC East. Is that concerning going forward? Is the NFC East getting a handle on how to handle Dak?
I think so. You know, you look at just his grades and overall his pass rating versus the NFC East, 2016 and 17 last season. Grade in the mid-50s for us, PFF grade, passer rating 79.7 versus the NFC East, versus all other teams, a 70 grade and a 96.9 passer rating against the rest of the league. So those teams have figured out different ways that they like to attack them. The Philadelphia Eagles is let's put pressure on them, cover zero. The Giants play a lot of man-to-man, tight coverage man-to-man. So they certainly have their ways. We'll see if the rest of the league can kind of catch up and maybe we'll see you know, him drop down a little bit in terms of that.
So the one last thing I want to hit on with Dak, for 2 years into the league, he's started to fall into a certain style. And if you've watched our QB clustering video, also here on the YouTube channel, we've broken down, you know, that's our way of putting guys into different tiers and defining their skill sets. Last year he was called a cluster two quarterback, essentially in the safer region, meaning he wasn't making those special downfield throws. He was also doing a pretty good job of taking care of the ball on a throw for throw basis. Last year, number 28 in the NFL in big time throw percentage, the 28th ranked quarterback. So that's not that high, but he was number 10 at avoiding turnover worthy plays.
Yeah.
And for two straight years, one of the lowest percentages of deep pass targets, even though when he's thrown down the field, he's been pretty good. Have we seen that's essentially where Prescott's going to settle in as the safer Alex Smithy type of quarterback?
I think he might be, and a lot of that has to do with just the running game and stuff like that. Maybe he doesn't feel like he has to take those chances down the field, but he does a great job of knowing when to tuck it, especially down in the red zone, can tuck it, use his legs, take off. You would like to see some more 20-plus plays off of play action. They use that bootleg game so well. You'd like to see them kind of get down the field a little bit more, him take some more chances because, like you said, when he's done it, it's been pretty effective. But he certainly takes care of the football, tucks it and runs, doesn't make too many bad decisions, especially late in
the
down.
The RPO game, that run-pass-option game in the red zone with Zeke back there, that's unstoppable. They've only pulled that out a handful of times in Dallas. Want to see more of that going forward because it just puts defenses in a bind. Real quick, let's touch on the playmakers because, again, his rookie season, I think Cole Beasley played a little bit better in the slot, a little bit better work from Dez Bryant when he was out there. But now you have Dez is moving on. Jason Witten's moving on, the top two pass targets the last couple of years. They're bringing in Allen Hurns. They drafted Michael Gallup and Cedric Wilson, two guys that we liked, but they went a little bit mid to late round there. What are the playmakers going to do this season in Dallas?
Yeah, they're trying to talk it up like everything's all good. They don't need a number one, and maybe they don't. Maybe they can get one of these guys to step up. I look at Michael Gallup as one of those guys, a very explosive guy, a guy that can separate. We've seen Dak Prescott a little more comfortable when he's got a little bit more separation with what he's looking at. Gallup is an explosive guy that can create separation. Cole Beasley, he's got to get back to 2016 Cole Beasley. He was not the same guy last year. I would expect him to kind of get his level of play back up because when you look at who's had the most catches over the last few years, Cole Beasley's that guy with Jason Witten now gone, Dez Bryant, like you mentioned. So Cole Beasley, Michael Gallup, I think those two guys got to get it going.
You expecting a bounce back from Dak this coming season?
I think so. The running game should be good, should be a good spot. I think overall maybe kind of fall in between somewhere, you know, from the first year to last year, maybe in the top, you know, 12 to 14 area.
So what I want to see from Dak heading into year three, I want to see some games where he is the guy, where he takes over. It's not just Zeke in the play-action game. It's a pass-first league. I want to see some games where they're throwing the ball 40, 45 times. He's the man, short passing game, stretch the field a little bit. I want to see Dak take over here in 2018. Go check out all the great information that we've just been using with our PFF Edge and Elite subscriptions, especially in our PFF QB Annual. And be sure to give us the old thumbs up on this video, like it, and share with your friends the PFF YouTube channel.